Alright guys, welcome back. So I'm going to be showing you guys the deck where it's at right now, right? Because that's what we want to find out. Is it viable? Is it not viable? How consistent is it? How resilient is it? And going into the format that we won't really know what it would be like, right? Because this is going to be released later in the year. So we don't know what's like main deck applicable and what side deck applicable. So it's like... So as of right now, we could just, I guess, generalize the deck, right? Just, okay, let's see. These cards go together. Look at this. Is crazy. This is the crazy. It's crazy. Double Veiler stuffed his setup, which is cool. So right here, I was kind of scared because of the last card in his hand. I wasn't sure if an Ash is over, but once he revealed that, I was like, oh, I have resolved everything. It's going to resolve. I use his Dragon Maid to make my speeder. Okay, so this is where, this is amazing. This card's amazing because like what this does, what Necrosynchronous does is if you don't open up Doppel, it's okay, because it just makes opening up Converter and any tuner full combo, because you see what I mean. Like you can get to two level ones, which is this card, right? Evilthorn, right? Evilthorn because basically essentially becomes a Doppel tip because you get two of them, right? So for those of you that don't know what this does, it's you can tribute this card, inflict 300 damage to your opponent, so it's good in time if you're gonna burn them in time. And if you do, you can special summon up to two Evilthorn from your deck in attack position, but their effects aren't good. So you just summon this, tribute its effect, get to two level ones, and then utilize them to like sink or climb, right? And you'll see how it's meant to be doing it here. Of course, I had to utilize the Cyber Synchron, so it kind of eh. But nonetheless, it's still showing you what it's capable of, which is awesome. Look at this. It's so cool. Just the versatility of his capabilities is amazing. So I'm like, I have to clear his board and then end on Savage. But I already have an Omnigate right here, watch. Look at this. So I'm like, okay, I need to trigger. Bring back a tuner, so I can maybe dragster or some anything I want. Right? It's that warrior puppet. I forgot I went to Battlefield as well. Which is like negate. But yeah, man, that was a really weird hand. Honestly, that was really weird. Going first. Oh, this deck loves to go first. Especially because it's so consistent, but I think the weak points are quite apparent, right? Like the choke point. If you summon junk and the imperm junk is like, oh, what do you do from there and on? Okay, this is gonna be the full combo of how to do it, right? This is gonna be like, okay, just follow along. Okay, so the reason you play Ignister is because for Necro Synchron, you need to synchro into a Wind Synchro to get its effect, right? Otherwise, it won't trigger. I was trying out Clearwing, but I don't know, like. I felt like Pegasus, it's just backer removal and it's utility after you synchro it away. Because after it's just a stepping stone, right? You're not really going to keep it on board. It's just something you can just make and climb into the new level 10 synchro, right? And like, it's good because it's spot removal. You just lose one of your cards and then you just activate an effect in the grave and you spin a card in the graveyard on a field. It's like, okay, that's not bad at all. But this is basically the sequence, right? This is how you go off. Oh, that was a bit different. Yeah, this is a bit different. I think I forgot to send it beforehand. I don't know. No. Okay, no, yeah, this is right. Sling climbing, freestyling right now. Trying to get things going. Oh, this is where the timer was gonna get to me, I think. I'm pretty sure if I remember correctly, this was the timer. I was like, oh no. Crystalline. Yeah. Yeah, look at this board, man. Look at this board. No, never mind. I think this is the one with the timer. Where I was like, oh man, what am I gonna do? Timer, Dragon Link again. Combo deck versus combo deck. Veiler. Seals. Okay. But she should have gone for something else there, right? I'm pretty sure. Yeah, like, oh, I don't know. Savage. Pretty sure she could have done something differently. I don't know. I'm not sure if he knows exactly how to play this. But okay, so I had to let. Okay, so let's just do this. The gate. It's hard to like not ignore this. Look at this. Oh man, I baited both interactions. I was like, it's fine then. Because if you guys are aware, this guy searches this card, and then this card can reduce or increase its level, and I reduced it to make a speeder. And how cool is that, dude? Just little clever plays you can do that Stardust Synchron can provide are really hopeful. Like, it's like, oh, that's cool, you can do that. Like, that's amazing. And I just try to go for that. I'm trying to sequence it off into a satellite ore because I want to just destroy this entire board. And I was thinking of how to do it, right? Because I was like, okay, because you have to think ahead with these decks. Like, sequencing, because, like, The combo isn't really linear. Like, you have the same stepping stones to get to a particular combo, but more often than not, it's gonna be very different. Most of the time, right? It's gonna be okay. There'll be time where you do Shaman first, and there's gonna be time where you do Marcher first, and like, it's one of those decks that. It's cool like that. It's unique in that way, where it's a high sequence deck, and you can maneuver and then I guess improvise as you're comboing off, which is the exciting part. Oh, this is where I was testing out Clear Wound Synchro, and then I was like, oh no, I think I prefer Pegasus, because like I said, it was just a stepping stone. It was just something to climb into. So I was like, oh, I'm not really going to utilize its effect on the field, so why not just get something that has a grave effect? And Pegasus just fit that description really, really well. This card's cool. The thing about this card is that it's only once on the field. So like, if you need to get on your turn, if you need to get Nibiru on your turn, and then you pass, you can't get it again, because it's only once while it's faced up on the field. But typically what you can do is set it up to where you can... threaten negating Nibiru, and then during the stamina phase you revive something, or whether it be Excel or Quandex. You get dusted, man. But it's hard not to see this. You'd be drawing so much, and then just make it again, and just have another Omni. It's basically over, man. But then there's also those games where it can be very discouraging. Oh, this is gonna be okay. So if you've been paying attention, these past replays I've been opening up with this guy, and it's okay with that because you can just revive it with Converter's effect, and then just get its effect regardless if you don't summon it off speeder, because you can just, it triggers in grave, so it's effects negator on the field, but in grave it's a different card, right? Look at that. Trigger it. It's so cool, like that. Just Converter alone, like that makes Converter so much. Of course, it's like, oh, you gotta run three bricks, I guess, if you draw into them, which is something I think that has to be addressed, considering that it's gonna be a key part of the combo. So, like, implementing cards that can synergize with Evil Thorn, right? Like its tribute effect aspect, or just the fact it's a level 1 plant, the dark, not too sure, it's just, I don't know, like, you want to be able to have it just be relevant without just having it just be summoned off of Necro Synchron, going against Virtual, the modern Synchro deck, right? It's the Synchro deck that's out right now. Still pretty decent what it does now. It's Dragoons, Crystal Wing, Chooch, right? Just negate everything, destroy everything. And just when you thought it was clear, just take it away. Just take it away with him. He tries to pop my Barones. of Cyber Singers and Cards, so it's gonna stay there. This game was crazy. This game was like, oh, look at this full combo. Except once again, I'm drawing into the Garnet Synchrons that you don't really want to draw. But again, like Converter can just revive it if you really need their level. So it's as if you summon it off Spear, you know? Look at this. That's send Trail. Trail is actually quite important because of Thorn. Because you can just trigger Trail off of effect. Look at this. Look at this. Effect. This was cool about it. You can just use Shaman's effect, bring back two level twos, and just tribute one for start a synchron. How cool is that? Just utilizing Librarian's effect to its fullest potential. Just draw into hand traps, and then Pot of Avarice to just do it again next turn if you get broken. Look at this board. I think this is the best board you can make. I think with Herald would be the best board. Just Omega. Why didn't he do that first? I was like, oh my gosh, he revealed Poly. It's like, there's no way he has a Poly target, right? And I'm like, a Machine Light, a Warrior Wind, a Warrior Dragon. I mean, a Wind Dragon. And I'm like, what the hell? I was like, oh, did I just lose after I ended up my freaking best board? And he goes Hulk, and he goes Zom. I was like, oh my god, I think I just lost. He goes Beldurok. He's gonna kill my Dragster. All I'm gonna have is a... And this is what I meant about Pegasus. Like, it just spot removal. And so that helped me a lot, because it didn't let him trigger his Beldurok, which is insane. So right here, I'm trying to just see if he takes the bait, and just turn the sequence off to see, okay, what does he do? What's he going to do with this? He's two back rows, so like maybe he has another super poly. Maybe just Eldritch traps. Like a Scarlet and a Conquistador or a Aquero. So like, I can play around that. So I was playing around that, just trying to bait him to like use the effect. But he wasn't biting, and then he strikes me. I'm like, okay. And I was like, double strike. But luckily, me being a beast, I counted for that. Well, not really. But I counted for one strike at least. At worst case scenario, not two. And it just ended up working out because I just recycled the Silent Warrior. Okay, so here's the deck list, right? It's very minor changes. The only biggest change is like Pot of Avarice. Because, you know, guys, I've always liked playing this at three. It's just amazing. I've always thought this was like an amazing thing. But I was like, oh, let me just get really down to it, right? Get really like before, like if you remember from Dark Synchro days, where I was very, very specific on ratios. And I was very like, okay, this has to be at one. Every ratio had its purpose, right? So thinking about that now with this particular build, it seemed to work out. But I still feels kind of weird playing this at that one. But yes, okay, so the new card that I've been testing was Evil Thorn, right? Because it's a card you summon off of a Necrosynchron. It's a plant, it's a level 1 plant, and it's essentially a double warrior. So it makes opening up Converter better, right? It hires the ceiling of Converter. And potentially allowing us to cut Doppel. Because Doppel, it's as good as it is, and as much as it hires the ceiling of the deck, it can be a bit bricky, because you need to resolve junk for it to resolve. Otherwise, it's just a dead card, which is why I'm playing this little package, because special make Shaman, and then summon the level twos from like that way, and then if they interact with that sequence, then you just summon junk, right? So like trying to accommodate makes it a little bit weird, right? Because like, you don't really want to be in that spot. You want to make sure that you just resolve the junk and then combo off, and then, you know. So if you open up Doppel this and like this, like it doesn't really do anything. Like it's Doppel, junk, Evil Thorn, this Ash, Failure doesn't do anything. Unless you go in second, then you have something to revive. But if you go in first, it doesn't really do anything. Like, the best thing you can do is make a herald pass, and that's not really ideal. Same thing, and then like if which is why, like, going back to this, like, this is why this has synergy with that. Special, summon, do marcher play, or just this and this, make shaman, and etc., right? So taking that away and adding something else, but that's the issue, right? What else would I add? Would it be just more hand traps? Would it be just more interactions? You know, like, it'll just fall back on that. If this is out, do I really need this then? Because, like, I don't really need to do the shaman play, because the shaman play becomes not as important. And then you gotta talk about is shaman even needed at that point? Because, like, oh, you're gonna revive a converter? Okay, what's that really gonna do? So it's like it just starts unraveling into, like, questioning everything once you take away Adapo out of the equation, which is where I'm at right now. But nonetheless, it's just very toolboxy, right? But it's just 1/1, 1/1/1. The Dustscaper is just like a toolbox card. You just summon it off of this, because there's times where you need that level one, because level ones are quite crucial for this type of deck, because you want to be able to link Synchro Climb. And yeah, it's just really, really cool. I don't know, but that's basically going to be it. I'm going to keep testing this, and I know it's been like gaps of the timelines of when I upload, but it's just I'm still trying to figure that out. But yeah, that's gonna be it. Hopefully you'll be, before this was twisters and droplets, but like I said, it was inconsistent, because this has more synergy with converter than these do, because, like, the only time this has synergy with the converter is if you have junk and then you can discard and then summon back the converter and then do it that way. But that wasn't always the case. So that's why I went back to, like, the tuner hand traps, because they work well with this card. But that's basically it. go ahead and test it out. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Like, subscribe if you haven't. And thanks for watching.